Hi, welcome. Today we are going to see how to send smart home notifications onto your TV. For this purpose, I am using a Fibaro smart home. Using Fibaro smart home, you can use a virtual device or scenes to make these notifications. As far as a TV, I am using a Kodi media player. My Kodi media player is the one that I'm using on my TV. It looks great on TV. It is a free media player. I'm just showing you how to get it. You can go into this link and get the Kodi software. The greatest benefit of Kodi is the add-ons that it comes with. It has thousands of add-ons. These are some of the most popular add-ons. So if you go into the add-ons, yeah, you can see that there's a lot of cool add-ons. Exodus, GNA, etc., etc. So Exodus is one of the most popular ones. It allows you to watch premium content, online content, streaming content for free. So yeah, back to our topic. So coming to Kodi, the strength of Kodi lies in its API. Kodi has a very robust JSON RPC API. We are clicking to that. So this is the link for the JSON RPC. So we are going into the latest one. So for sending notifications, just I'm searching for Kodi notification. Yeah, so this is a structure that the smart home needs to send the command format. You can see that you have a title, you have a message. This is what needs to appear onto your TV. So how does it really look in your TV? So this is how it will look like. On the right side, you get something, right? There's going to be the title, and below that you have a message. So in case something happens in your smart home, there's a pop-up that's coming on the TV that says, for example, if someone's at the door, it says someone is at the door, check the main door or whatever. We can design the notification in whatever way we want. So coming into our smart home, so for Fibaro, we are going to get into here in this case, I'm going to be trying to send it through a virtual device, because if you want to go into through scenes, you will not be able to send these using a home center light, because there's no Lua in home center light. So we'll stick to the basics, that is through the virtual device. I'm adding a new virtual device, give it a name, and you either put it into a room or keep it in unassigned, it's up to you. For IP address, type in the IP address of the Kodi or XBMC player. I'm right now, the port is 8080. I'm right now running it on a Raspberry Pi, which I'm connecting it to the TV through a HDMI cable. So I'm adding some buttons, I'm giving it a name. So in case if someone calls the door, rings the bell, I'm going to be sending a notification for that. I'm creating two buttons. Okay, so I've created two buttons. I need to save it and I need to have a code over here. So basically it's a little bit, you can send get commands or post commands. But I don't like to construct my commands here, because I don't have a proper way to debug a lot of things in a home center light. It's very difficult to do that. So in that case, I will like to use a software called Postman. So for Kodi notification, let me see if I have some example commands. So I'm just searching the web for that. I remember seeing, yeah, this link. This link has a nice format, command format. So here, it's a curl command. It's basically a post. They're using curl software to do that. But I can't give the whole thing as it is into Fibaro, because Fibaro doesn't accept it in this form. So I need to give it in a proper format, like post followed by the command and the body and with proper headers. I need to do that. So I don't like to construct the command here. Instead, I like to use a software called Postman. This is also a free software. You can download it by choosing your whichever Windows you have, you choose it. I've already installed it. Yeah, over here. So it's quite simple. I'll tell you how to construct the command over here. You can give a new command. Yeah, and just choose between get and post. Choose post because the newer versions of Kodi does not support get. So inside this, I need to give the IP address of my Kodi player, which is this one, and the port number also, followed by the command slash json rpc. Next, I need to give the information for header. So I don't need to give the whole lot of headers. The most important one is the content type, and also you need to give it as application json. Then I need to get all these information into the postman. So I'm going to type that out into the body part. Here I'm going to use a raw text. So type in So when I'm typing here, just remember to get your title and message ready. Make sure you don't make any spelling mistakes. Of course, postman will help you if you do make any mistakes. I'm going to be typing the params. So here is where I will be giving the title. My title followed by the message. The doorbell alert will be a little bit in a bigger size, followed by the title. Right, and of course at the end we need to give the ID parameter. This ID parameter, without this I'm not really sure why we need this ID, what it denotes, but without this the command does not work. It is also it's mentioned in the JSON RPC spec. Right, so now we've finished the command, so let us just try sending it. I sent the command to my Kodi player. Click. So I'm getting a response. It's 200. Good. 200 means it reached it, it succeeded. Yeah, it says something wrong. Okay, I missed the colon. Let me put the colon and send. So yeah, everything is fine. Things are all right, which means the command succeeded and passed. So now the beautiful thing about Postman is I can get the headers, all these headers, in a proper format instantly. So for this, I need to get into this code section. Make sure you've selected HTTP. You get all the headers, all the temporary headers, whatever it is. So just make sure that you've turned this on. In case you've turned it off, you won't get a lot of headers. Without that, Fibaro doesn't work. So you get the whole section. So take everything, copy paste into your Fibaro's virtual device. Okay, let's move into Fibaro's virtual device. Yeah, paste it over here and we are done. We'll save it and we will send the command. Okay, so now we send the command. So you can see I'm sending it. Yes, we've got the notification, doorbell alert. So thanks for watching. Please do subscribe if you like the contents. Thank you. Bye-bye.